Thank you.
First challenge is to get it over to you all within 20 minutes. If we have a tour within the edge, we prognose it takes 1.5 hours, and eventually it takes 2 hours sometimes. So I would like to speed up a little bit, otherwise my time is really limited. As indicated, responsible for a client. My client is Deloitte, and Deloitte Netherlands was in more or less the same position as SAP was. Two office buildings, and what was their opinion? They wanted to go to one central new building, and oh, by the way, it should be state of the art. It should be the edge of what is possible. So this is the edge. Nice building, really nice building, in the center city of Amsterdam Financial Center. So that means that it's expensive ground. What do? You compress and you go into height. So what we did is we took two offices, or Deloitte took two offices, which were massive, and we tried to compress it as good as possible. After everything that Peter indicated, meetings with the various stakeholders, personas have been created, etc. At that moment, the design by the architect of the building was ready. And at that moment, facility management was linked to IT services. So that means that the CIO of Deloitte took ownership of FM. And he said, I love FM. Still, I have my opinions about the catering, but okay, I truly, sincerely find that FM is done well, but I don't find it challenging. And since I'm in charge now and we are building the most sustainable office building in the world, I also want to have it the most innovative office building in the world. Having said that, how do you convince people? They convinced people by releasing this movie 2 years approximately prior to opening of the building. So this is the edge and the end of my story. No, that's not correct, but I would like to tell you more about the vision and the management. As Dutch, we are not so good at football anymore, the last period, but I hope we can convince you that we build a nice office in the Amsterdam area. So the vision once again, Deloitte wanted to compress two various departments within the organization together. Deloitte itself is changing. They are no longer an accountancy firm only. They're also going into consulting, risk, cybersecurity, cyber technology, everything that concluded that something else needs to change. So if we take a look at the vision, of course, number one, always drive down costs. We drop two offices and we go back to one, and we want to go back in cost. So you compress it, you put more persons on a square meter, but not by reducing the number of offices. We did it smart, we did it different. And on the other hand, since Deloitte is moving more and more into data analytics, they said we want data. We want sensors in the property, and these sensors we will be using for optimizing our way of working for everybody involved. What another objective was, collaboration. Two various parties need to come together. What do? You create workspaces where people sit together, work next to each other, and start having conversations. Because apparently everybody is working or might be working for the same client, only on a different way of, in another atmosphere. So somebody is accounting and the other one is consulting. What do you want? You want these people to interact. We started at this location with hospitality. Why hospitality? We want to be the showcase for everybody to come in, and everybody needs to have feel a warm welcome. So this is actually the edge. If you take a look at the building, it's the most sustainable, or at least it was last year, the most sustainable office building in the world. It has been built in a shoehorse shape, and the sun is turning around. So what you saw in the movie is that the facade is being, the solar panel are being placed on the facade. If you know something about solar panels, you know you never put them horizontal or vertical on a facade. They did it, why? Solar panels are cheaper than marble on the external of a building, and at the end of the line, they generate energy. So that energy can be used. So we hardly use energy in this property because of what has been installed. And on the other end, on the right side, you see that they store energy 130 meters down in the ground, warm and cold, and it's being used to heat up or to cool the building. That makes this the most sustainable office building at the moment it was handed over to us from operations. In the movie, there was one thing which was not correct. The movie you just saw. There was a lady touching the glass panel and it was fading over into a display. That's not reality. That was a prognosis which didn't come to a conclusion. The rest did. So what do we have? We have dashboards. Our facility manager, my colleague, is able to take a look at the dashboard where he can see the occupancy rate, he can take a look how many lockers are in use, what the status of the coffee machines are, etc. I will deep dive in some of these elements later on. Here you have an impression of the dashboard. So what you can see is on the right side of the circle, we can see on distance how many cappuccino and how many coffee has been sold. Nice feature, but we want to know because we need to fill the milk, because the milk is the most critical element in an office like the edge. So if you don't have enough milk, you are having complaining staff members. So what do? You want to monitor all these kind of things. We can monitor the number of visitors inside. So that means that we are able to prognose for our catering company how many lunches they should be preparing, because there's a lot of guests in the property. We never know if they will be there at 12:30, but at least at 11 o'clock, we have a prognose, and we can do something with that. If you take a look at this, and these are not the nicest pictures, you see the coffee machines. High standard coffee machine, linked to the internet. We'll deep dive in that one later. Clean desk policy. Except for a couple of staff members, nobody, not even partners, directors, owners, have an own desk. Initially, complaints, absolutely, before we went live. But after we went live, all involved, even the partners indicated, I'm working different when I'm in the edge because I'm working more with my colleagues than instead separated from my colleagues. So if I'm working from home, I'm more effective in producing, but as I'm working on the office, I've got more interaction with my staff and I can delegate better and I have better understanding of what's ongoing. So we embrace the philosophy of clean desk, no assigned desks anymore. Please stop with this. And what you see on the right side is the lockers. Since we have a clean desk and unassigned, nobody has his own space to store anything. The only thing we have is an archive. You can archive your books, whatever you want, in your archive, in a general archive, or in the morning you can take one of the lockers by offering your badge and you can open it and you can close it again. And in the evening, offer your badge and take your stuff out. We call it hot desking. It's a multi-tenant building. The building was designed before the crisis hit in. At the moment the crisis came in, the tenants, which is Deloitte, thought, oh my goodness, are we going to get it full? And they decided to go on the market. So they leased out approximately 25-30% of the floor surface. If you take a look at the situation now, they never should have been doing that. But at the end of the line, it's done, and we're still working over there, and it's working fine. What I would like to give to you is some examples of what we did different in regards with regards to facilities management. And afterwards, at the end of the line, I want to tell you the lessons learned we had with implementing such an innovative system. So we have four elements I would like to highlight. Locker systems. This is not the actual lockers, but to give an overview, we can see real time, any time of the day, what the occupancy rate of the lockers is. Why? Every locker is linked to the internet. And since it's on the internet, we know who is owning what locker, what duration that person is using it, so we can send out a mail if they start using it as an archive. We can, if we want to, open and close lockers. And we can take a look by using the app, which is in design or being designed. We can take a look real time, but also all users can take a look where there are in the property free lockers available. If you take a look at the coffee machines, as I indicated, linked to the internet. So we know the number of coffees served in general. That's good for maintenance. We know the number of cappuccinos served. That's good to fill out the coffee machines, sorry, the milk containers. We know when to fill it, but we can also run data analytics on it. So we know that a coffee machine on the first floor is most occupied at 10 o'clock in the morning, by example. And we also know that at 12 or 2 o'clock, it's hardly used. So when do you do the big cleanup, which is taking 20 minutes? You do it at 1 o'clock instead of at 10 o'clock. That is using the internet to come to a better outcome with more satisfaction for the users. On the other hand, you can say to the coffee machine filling group, they have a handheld, they can have a handheld, and they get a real-time alert if one of the machines can go into an error. At that moment, they can start working, and they know they solve it just in time or just too late. You don't see it quite easily, but we have towel dispensers in the toilet areas, which is a standard towel dispenser, which is linked to the internet. So data privacy, yes, no problem at all. We don't know who's going to the toilet at what time and how often. But we do know the occupancy rate of the toilets, because I assume that everybody in this room will wash his hand and dry his hands afterwards. So if everybody does that, as it should be, then we know how often the toilet has been used. So instead of sending over a cleaner 4 times a day because we decided to work like that 2 years ago, we can say, oh, the peak is at 1 o'clock. We see it in the data, so we have an additional cleaning round at that moment. And we can stop the cleaning round at 11 o'clock because apparently nobody is using the toilet at that moment. And then the lighting system. Deloitte linked up with Philips. And Philips indicated, we are working on a lighting system linked to the internet. And they said, we are not ready. And both companies eventually took the effort of getting the lighting system ready prior to opening. So what does it mean? That the lighting systems is not powered by the normal powered socket, but it's powered by internet. That means that every light fixture has its own IP address. So that means that if you equip a light fixture with a sensor, the sensor gives you valuable information where you can use for occupancy, for temperature, for humidity, for all these kind of elements. All these elements I just showed, including additional ones, resulting in more than 20,000 sensors in the edge. So 20,000 sensors times the number of data it generates, there's a data center, and we want to store the data over there so we can data analytics that data. If we take a look at the lessons learned, it was a tremendous project. We got a lot of positive exposure. A lot of things went well. Some of the elements didn't go well. And I promised my client not to tell them. No, we are quite open in what went well and what didn't well. So if you take a look at the good things from a tenant perspective, so my client, they're happy because they only have 1,100 workplaces on 2,500 staff members. I'm in doubt if companies are able to achieve this number of workplaces on that amount of staff members. Yes, of course, we have a restaurant, we have a lot of open area where people can sit, but if you take a look at the official workplaces, it's only that amount of workplaces. The barriers were broken down because people were sitting next to each other and talking to each other. People find the edge attractive, resulting in more than a double of the number of job applicants for the edge only. People coming from high school indicated, I want to work at the edge, so I'm going to drop my CV or my resume at that company because I want to work there. More collaboration, so that means that partners and everybody are happy because there's more cooperation between each other and more focus on well-being. So you build an office which is sustainable and also you want well-being for your users. And that's what we embedded and I think which went well. Let's take a look. Lessons learned from a user perspective. Initially, there was launched an app, and that app is on your telephone, and you should be logging in, and you should be scrolling down, and it was quite difficult to get that launched. So people didn't use it. So one of the and another element was wireless connection of the TV screens in the meeting rooms. The first time I needed to connect it, it took me more than 10 minutes. That's not good in a meeting for 30 minutes. So my advice would be build it simple and where possible, use a wire because it is more sustainable or more easy than it is doing it wireless. We have on each desk a QR code. If I come in, I check in on the QR code, and if Peter comes in the office, he can see, by using his app, he can see what desk I'm located at that moment. Unfortunately, people don't use it. So out of 1,100 desks, only 20, 40, 60 persons are logging in each day. They should be all doing it, because then I am able to contact you and to walk towards you, unfortunately. We gave too many tours. At the end of the line, it was buses stopping in front of the building and asking us for tours. And some of the persons over here in the room also joined one of the tours. I hope they joined it. It was too many, so we killed them almost all. What we did well at the end of the line was involve the staff members. Like Peter indicated, we gave so much communication that people were overwhelmed by it and they were happy to come into the edge in November 2014. I went too fast. One specific element, 20,000 sensors. You might say you have all the data. Yes, we have all the data. But you're also working with suppliers. A supplier from Germany is not that easy to get data from because there's something with privacy and sharing data, etc. So one of the lessons learned, we know if you ever go this route, resolve contractual by testing upfront. Ensure that the data is delivered in time, in the good methodology, and in the good sequence, because otherwise it's worthless. We're working on getting some of the data still resolved. We have it in place a little bit, but sometimes we need to restore it. Another element, Deloitte was in the driver's seat for the building. We were in driver's seat after innovations have been born, but we were deeply involved 2 years prior to opening from an FM point of view. So a senior facility, a senior project manager joined the group, and that helped us as an FM team a lot because after opening, we didn't have any complaints and also the users didn't. We trained all FM staff. They were a bit angry, but in the weekend prior to opening, everybody was running around in the building and we were telling them everything, how it worked, resulting in a smoothless opening. And one of the important things, especially for big companies, dare to work with startup companies, because startup companies can give you, and in my opinion, will give you the drive to go to real innovations. And if you take a look from collaboration, all suppliers were periodically forced into a room and they were sitting together and they're making the same objectives. We want a security robot. We want this in place. We want that in place. And if you have the same mission, you will succeed, which we did at opening. And the design teams, there were specific design teams involved to get everything in place. That's it? Red? Just in time.